fresh on Franklin Group. We are providing healthy food within our community. In this challenge, we have found several ways to implement healthy food options, awareness of nutrition, and even address the food issues in our Westinghouse community, and eventually the entire community.
In today's society, youth have developed a culture of unhealthy eating habits. As we embark on this challenge, we notice many students within our community living in food deserts, thus having the inability to access nutritional food on a daily basis. And it's not uncommon to see students eating hot chips, honey buns, or drinking syrupy sodas in class. Students report that their breakfasts are often processed food and that it is no different at home. However, in a survey of our classmates, we learned that healthy eating is important to them. And many students were interested in buying healthier options or learning about nutritional changes they can make to their diets.
The big question that we ask is, how can we offer healthy food options to the youth at Westinghouse? How can we teach them about nutrition and still ensure a sustainable outcome? One way that we did this is by creating the Fresh on Franklin store at Westinghouse, which sells pretzels, trail mix, and yogurt. We have did this to compete with the unhealthy snacks such as chips, pop, and candy bars. We sell 2 days out of the week. And so far, we have made $150. Teachers and students alike have both agreed that these healthy food options have created a positive change. It is a good option for kids staying after school for activities such as detentions, sports, and tutoring.
In addition to expanding our school store's options, we have planned a course that's part of our curriculum at Westinghouse. We have Community Day, which is a day that focuses solely on the elective portion of school that consists of yoga or woodworking and now nutrition. This day is giving us an option to expand our knowledge as well as our experience with healthy foods.
We are pleased to announce that administration has approved the Fresh on Franklin Community Day course. So, within this course, students will be able to continue the work of the Aspen Challenge team. On this team, people will have the option. We have developed a curriculum for the year that allows students to continue brainstorming and planning for how to continue to make change, in addition to maintaining the website we have begun and maintaining the new, healthier school store. This will be sponsored by our Aspen Co., who will be facilitated by us. It will be a team and a class that continues to grapple with the issues and continues to problem solve and make changes towards this challenge. Part of the curriculum includes a social media presence with a Fresh on Franklin website, recipe creation, and work in the courtyard garden to produce more fresh food right here in school.
Finally, our solution also includes a kickoff event at the beginning of the year to show support for the programs that were started this year, but also to engage parents and community members into making Westinghouse a healthier place in the new upcoming year. We are partnering with the Make a Challenge team at our school so that we can achieve both of our focus areas, that being nutrition and fitness. Our PE department is currently working with our Make a Challenge team to do a fun run fundraiser, and we plan to have local fresh, local markets, local farmers markets, and food trucks to sell fresh foods at the event. And community members, students, parents, and teachers alike will have a chance to see that Westinghouse embraces activity and healthy eating.
We have not achieved every aspect of our goal, and we all are aware of the regulations and red tape that CPS has put in place that don't allow us to have food vendors and other things like that that we will have. We would like to have part of our solution. However, we have created a project that we really believe in and that we think is sustainable. We have worked within our school community that has created a plan that won't last just the 6 weeks, but for the next school year and every other school year after that. We hope that the curriculum, the Fall Fest, and the rest of our plan will help implement healthy food options into our community and inspire other schools around us in our local areas to help make healthy eating.
Let me have a round of applause.
Well, for me, when we had our first meeting, I had brought a bag of Chippewa Hoys. They were good to me. And then when we started going through healthy eating and implementing healthy eating and the effects of healthy eating, now I'm bringing trail mix and like apples to the meeting. So.
And also, I sell at the store a lot. And you know, you try to attract the healthy eating to teenagers, but it's hard. But one way I decided to do that was, you know, to get the seniors who are about to go on prom, have to get their body right. I'm like, come on, you know, you got to fit into that dress or that tuxedo. So that's one way I attracted them.
In addition, like anywhere that you go, I mean, when like before the challenge, like it was okay, I know it's just not healthy and I eat it, but now it's like before going into you like. For some reason, the like, instinct is just to read the nutritional facts, which, yeah.
What's been the response in your school? What have the kids said when they come up to buy the stuff at the store? Both the positive reaction and then maybe the skeptical reaction.
Okay, so we had a report card pickup, and initially we were kind of competing with another fundraiser at the school store, and it was like half and half, and I was helping with both, so we would have like, healthy trail mix compared to Doritos, and at first I was like, come on, no. You're gonna be my friend and you're gonna do this. I feel like having like, you just explain to them like, you can get this here for a lot cheaper than you would over there, and I feel like that was initially like, made it more positive, the fact that you can get it for a dollar compared when you go to the corner store, chips are for a dollar, and the trail mix is $2. So that was an impact that was.
Any other questions?
One more question. So since you said there was a lot of red tape with the school and being able to be a vendor inside the school, do you have any ideas on how you would create maybe challenges within the class body to continue healthy eating that doesn't require them to buy anything from you, but maybe bring an apple to school a day or something like that? Is there any thoughts on how you would sustain the program beyond the challenges?
Yeah, so part of our solution is, as we mentioned, was the community day class, and in that we're we hope to start our greenhouse in our garden. So we will be, we have many ideas about the vertical garden and different ways to grow food. And they can have access to, you know, the food on campus because, you know, the regulations were regarding people coming onto our campus and selling us things like that. So if we grow it in our, we have a courtyard. If we grow it in our courtyard, that would reduce that problem.
And also I would like to add on that the community classes for sure go. We already have all the students signed up for it, and we have the sponsor for it. And also, all of the funds paid, well, a majority of the funds that we received from grants, we're going to use it to, you know, buy materials for the class, and so that we could actually get this greenhouse project done.
Let's give them a round of applause.